Praise the Lord. Welcome to the sessions of 7 prophetic blessings of the day from Kadosh Marian Ministries. According to Ephesians chapter 2 verses 2 and 3, in which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world and of the ruler of the kingdom of the air, the spirit who is now at work in those who are disobedient. All of us also lived among them at one time, gratifying the cravings of our flesh and following its desires and thoughts. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath. This is the word of the Lord. Today's theme for the Immanuel Experience is freedom from guilt. Feeling of guilt arises from betraying our own rules and ethical behavior. If these rules belong to someone else, you would be guilt-free. But if, however, unconsciously or consciously, you are affiliated with these blameworthy standards, or perhaps in growing up embedded them from your family, you will be vulnerable to these self-tormenting emotions. The word of the psalmist strike a familiar note. My guilt has overwhelmed me like a burden too heavy to bear. You know my folly. Oh God, my guilt is not hidden from you. Let us try to understand a few methods to overcome guilt. Number 1. Guilt offering. In Old Testament times, when a person broke the law and offended God, he brought a lamb as guilt offering. The priest offered it as a sacrifice to atone for the sin. Long before Christ's birth, Isaiah prophesied that Messiah himself would become a guilt offering. Jesus Christ is the only atoning sacrifice for our guilt. Trust Him, He has already taken the punishment of our sins. Number 2. Understand guilt. Most of the time, we feel guilty because we have done or said something that caused harm to someone else. This type of guilt helps you to understand when you may be fault for something which is healthy and normal. There are healthy as well as unhealthy guilts out there. For example, if you forget a friend's birthday, you might feel guilty because friends are expected to remember and celebrate their friend's birthday. This is healthy guilt because it alerts you to something you failed to do that may damage your relationship with that person. An example for the unhealthy guilt is that if you are scheduled to work or if you are forced by your manager to work, then it is beyond your control. Your friend should understand that you had to miss their party in order to keep their job or responsibilities. So identify what you feel guilt about. If you feel guilty about something, it is important to identify what you feel guilty about and why, whether it is healthy guilt or unhealthy guilt. Identifying the source of your guilt and why it makes you feel guilty can help you to determine if you are experiencing healthy or unhealthy guilt. Either way, you will need to work through these feelings in order to overcome them. Listen carefully, breakthroughs are coming for the next points. Number 3. Write about your feelings. Journaling about your guilt may help you to start to understand it and deal it. Start by writing down the reason that you feel guilty. If it was something you did or said to someone, describe what happened in as much detail as you can. Include in your description how the situation made you feel and why. What do you think that you should feel guilty about? For example, you might write about the reasons why you forgot your friend's birthday or why you missed your friend's birthday. What was going on that and how did your friend react? How did that make you feel? Number 4. Respond divinely. God, one who knows all about guilt, think and act the antidote. Apology and forgiveness are the two tools which you can apply here. Apologize if necessary. Once you have determined whether or not your guilt is healthy or unhealthy, you can determine if you need to apologize for your actions. In the case of forgetting about your friend's birthday, you should apologize because you failed to do something that friend are supposed to do. In the second case, you couldn't attend because of your workload or your other responsibilities. You have to inform to them, you have to educate them and to convince them. The most important thing is that whether your friend agree or not, You should not keep this in your heart. It should not allow to grow as an unforgiveness.
Remember that true guilt is, of course, that which results from God's judgment, not man's. It is not myself or another who can determine my guilt, but God, He Himself. If the only just judge is God, then I must go to Him to decide whether or not I am guilty.
There is one another type of guilt which is called false guilt.
False guilt is what you feel when you assume the blame for someone else's wrongdoing. Abuse victims often carry such a burden, feeling they surely must have done something wrong to deserve the abuse. But when a victim finally learns to release the burden of false guilt and to repent for his or her own of unforgiveness in the matter, the bondage is broken.
Number 5. Change guilt to gratitude. Feeling guilty may cause you to think guilty thoughts, which are unproductive and do not provide you with anything that you can apply to your future behavior. Instead, try turning your guilt thoughts into a gratitude thoughts. Change guilt statement to positive one, such as, I'm grateful for the reminder that my friends are important to me and the chance to demonstrate that to them in the future. Send a message something like this to your friend and he will be healed. Number 6. Take a lesson from this and continuously use a calendar or a planner.
Number 7. Confess and rebuke the spirit of guilt. When the Holy Spirit convicts us of sin, we must confess it, turn from it and receive God's forgiveness and cleansing. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. If the devil keeps stirring up guilt, even after you have confessed and repented before the Lord and received His cleansing, you need to vigorously stand against the adversary. You can simply say, yes, I did that and it was wrong, but I have asked my Heavenly Father to forgive me. Satan, you cannot keep tormenting my mind with that offense. The blood of Jesus covers it. Now be gone in Jesus' name. And say loudly that it is between you and the Lord and your friend. The spiritual enemy does not have any authority to torment here or to disturb you about this. As Lord wanted to bless you, we are blessing you from the house of God. May you be able to confess your transgressions to the Lord and may the Lord forgive your guilt. May you be able to forgive your debtors and may the Lord forgive your debts. May the Lord help you to forgive whatever grievance you may have against one another. May the Lord draw you near to God and give you a heart of full assurance of faith and salvation. May God bless you. May God bless your endeavors. May God bless your family. We seal all these blessings in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm Thomas George from Kadosh Marian Ministries. Thank you.